Hi Scorpio, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. You can also visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com, and this is your monthly forecast for November 2015. Happy birthday Scorpios, and a very happy Diwali to you as well. We begin the month for the first 8 days we have a Venus and Mars conjunct that is happening, so both the planets are dancing in harmony together. And they're doing this beautiful celestial dance in a part of your chart that speaks about associations, it speaks about groups of people, it also speaks about dealing with people who could be having similar visions, similar goals as you. Now, whenever Venus comes and transits this part of a chart, it normally means that you will have friends or you will have people who are very supportive. Maybe your network is very supportive. Maybe the people whom you're reaching out to during this time are really there for you. This is also a time wherein that you will be looking at like-minded people. It can be that you could be looking for not necessarily religion, but it can be a spiritual group. It can be a hobby club. It can be something that you feel very passionately, strongly about, and then you get together with a couple of people, you form a club and you do something about it. It can also be joining an NGO or maybe doing something, some work with an organization or maybe a charity or an NGO way or for whom you feel very strongly for. It can also be that during this time, Scorpios, you just start dating somebody really new. It can be that this person you've known for a while is a friend and now turns into a date potential. It can also be that you meet somebody through a common friend who has similar interests as you and you started dating. Now, new moon is there in your own sign, Scorpio, and it's a very intense and a complex new moon during this time, and this is happening around the 11th. And because this is there in your own house, it's talking about your own dreams, desires, goals, and this entire shift that's happening for you, Scorpio, it's really putting a lot of focus on where you want to go, what you want to do in life, where is it that you see yourself somewhere down the future. So there's a lot of this sifting that is happening with this new moon energy, and it's quite an intense energy, and you're feeling quite intensely because this entire sifting is happening for you. And it's also a time where you're going to be making an effort to look good, and you're going to be sort of putting your best foot forward. So there's like a proper manicure and a pedicure done and spa. So not just even, I would say in some cases, even changing of a wardrobe or even changing your hairstyle drastically. So there's going to be a lot of emphasis on you putting focus on how it is that you project yourself to the world outside and how it is that you want the world to perceive you at large. It is consequently also a good time to be trying something which you could have been hesitant about earlier, or maybe you could have been a little shy about doing it. It's a time to be doing that as well. So it's a good exploratory things that could be fitting in very well with your core. But, you know, you could have earlier thought that, oh, you know, I can't be doing that. I have my responsibility. I have my career and so on and so forth. And oh, anyway, it's too much of a wishful thinking. This is a time where you'll realize, or rather an opportunity will come where you'll feel that, oh, this just fits in very well with what I want out of life for myself. And also this entire new moon Scorpio energy has sun and it has the energy of Mercury. So it's a nice mix, but of course the intensity and the complexity that Scorpio brings with itself is there. Now, since Scorpio is ruled by Pluto, that is the god of underworld, you can expect a lot of things, and because this has to do about you, they can start coming out from beneath the surface. You know, you may start digging a little bit more. Maybe earlier, if you've just sort of sat and you said that, okay, I don't really need to be sitting and worrying about it, it'll get sorted on its own. But this is a time where you're going to be picking up a shovel and you're going to start digging into your psyche. Where does this stem from? What is my belief system? Do I really subscribe to this? Is this my goal? Is this the future that I want for myself? These are all of the things that you are going to be looking at. And also, because Pluto is also all about under the hood, this is a time wherein that it's a good time to be getting any internal checkup. Scorpio also rules hematology, so it can be blood test. Maybe you have been trying to identify something. Maybe there's an iron deficiency that is there. Maybe you need to get that checked as well, a gynec check. Anything that has to do with your internal organs, or it has to do even with skin, underneath the skin, if something has been, you know, cropping up, allergies, and you've not been able to get a hold of what it is, this is a brilliant time to be doing all of that. Just sorting, sifting through. Since a lot of focus is there on your psyche as well, maybe for some of you, counseling could really help. This is a time wherein it's digging deep in the mind. You know, you want to get to the bottom of it and just get rid of the weeds which are not required during this time. It's a lovely time as well to be merging your resources and tallying your assets as well. So maybe you have a really diverse stock portfolio which is lying all over and you've not consolidated. Maybe it's not getting you much returns. So it's a good time to be looking at that. It's a great time to be reinvesting it further. It's also a great time, maybe, you know, you have some assets which are not, again, they're just lying. Maybe you have some cottage sitting somewhere or some land which is not doing you or not generating any kind of money for you. So this is a time where you can actually think of reinvesting, renting it out, selling it out, leasing it out. This is a time to be doing all that. Also a great time for mortgages, loans, EMIs. November is a great time, Scorpio, where you will be able to find some very good deals, especially as far as all these aspects are concerned. And even if you are thinking of partnering with somebody and buying something together, it will do you well, since this is also a time of combining resources, be it as simple as potluck, as simple as carpooling, or maybe even sharing a gym trainer. It's just the time for you to be combining, consolidating resources, looking at what it is, that the assets that you have, something that you can let go of, something that you can maybe rotate around, reinvest, liquidate, and just get in some cash, or maybe in a place wherein that, you know, the money is managed more well, or whatever the assets or the resources that you have is managed to its maximum. There's also a lot of focus on financial abundance, because Scorpio rules large sums of money as well. You know, it can be, and especially money which we share with others. So commissions, royalties, inheritances, all this is going to be coming, bonuses, all of that gets covered in this. However, this is a time really to be also sowing the seeds for your success, Scorpio. So don't be in a space wherein you want to be petty, or you want to hoard, or you don't want to give, or you're generally being in a vengeful that he did this to me, I will get back, and she did this to me some X years back, I will get back. Because this is something which will come and bite you back very badly. You are right now in a totally karmic boomerang space, Scorpio. So even if you do something really small, or if you, depending, it doesn't matter on the intensity of how big or small the spiteful act that you do, it will get you back. So please know that. And with this new moon energy in Scorpio, there, you know, Scorpio has three phases. So one is the lowest one, where you have that scorpion that it runs along the ground, you know, with venom in its tail, where it has that revengeful, bitter, you know, when it stings. And second phase of Scorpio is where he's the wizened eagle, and he's soaring over, and he can see everything, you know, down, he's soaring in the mountains. And the final is the highest form of Scorpio is the phoenix, wherein that he rises from the ashes and he literally reconstructs himself. So which is the energy of Scorpio that you want to use this new moon is entirely up to you. So whether you want to carry on being that vengeful, petty person and say, no, I am not going to let go, I shall be spiteful to him and I will be spiteful to her and I feel so hurt and I will not talk, you can carry on. It's quite all right. You will, you know, it'll unfortunately get reflected back. Even if not the phoenix, I would say, even if you feel it's too much of a task to be sort of reconstructing yourself from the ashes and recreating a new life, be the eagle. Be at least this wizened eagle who's now understood that, okay, there are these mistakes and I know that they are under my purview right now. And before you move to the third, you know, and eventually you will move to the third phase where you can sort of reconstruct everything and say, I don't need this, I need this, I can keep this with me, and whatever does not, it does not meet my requirement can go out of the door. So be on that phase at least, which is the second phase of Scorpio. We have a very interesting Venus rather the angle is interesting. That's Venus is in opposition to Uranus, and this is happening around the 23rd. And Uranus is there in your house of day-to-day chores. It's in your house of your health, and it can bring some amount of unpredictability. It can make you feel a tad erratic. And Venus is there in your house of spirituality. So this entire thing with this influence, especially with Venus being there in your spiritual space, you could feel almost like a karmic connection to someone. You could feel insanely attracted to somebody, and you could just feel as if there's a very strong attraction that is there, or there's, like I said, there's almost a karmic attraction that is there. And it's also a time wherein that you could meet somebody who's either in a hospital or is is pretty much a recluse, has not can be somebody who's been keeping to himself or herself. And it can be that the person subscribes to similar spiritual philosophies, and you could meet the person there. And Uranus now being over there, it's because it's there in your daily house, you need to be flexible to the change that is going to be happening in your day-to-day life as far as your diet, your health is concerned. And it can be that you would be required to change your schedule more than you would like. So stay flexible, Scorpions, and don't get too hassle around this time. End of the month, we have Saturn that is there in your house of resources, and it is squaring Neptune. Now, squares are not nice because that means both the planets don't like each other, you know, and Neptune is this really floaty, illusion, idealistic planet. And of course, you know, with Saturn, it is that he's a taskmaster, he's the effort, the worker. And when both of them obviously don't lie, because Saturn feels, you know, I mean, what the hell, you don't even like move, you keep having all these dreams around you. And Saturn is there in your money house. So Saturn is saying, you know, you need to be looking more carefully at your self-worth, and you need to be looking more carefully at your money. Are you identifying maybe a bit too much of your self-worth with the kind of money that you draw yourself? Now, this can be at both the extremes. It can be that you're drawing a lot of money, you're doing very well, and you have this really inflated ego, which really nobody can tolerate, but no one tells you because, you know, you are at a position and it's rude, end of the day. And on the other hand, if you're not doing well, you're starting off and so on and so forth, maybe you could be feeling quite undermined because you feel you're not earning as much as you should be earning. In both the cases, Saturn over here is saying that, you know, you need to be sort of taking stock of your own effectiveness. You need to be taking stock of, you know, not just the money that you have, but your own competency and your capabilities. And you need not worry, Scorpius, because the money, though it can be slow during this time, but it will be steady. And it's just about a perception that you have about the financial success and your own self-worth. And Neptune, of course, because it is there in your house of love, talking about, you know, that you are looking at relationships, you're looking maybe at your children, you're looking at creativity, you're looking at everything with this rose-colored glasses and idolizing it maybe too much and saying, oh, this needs to get done. And it can also be a time where you can find a hard time falling in love with the right people. So don't be the, what is the word for it? Don't be a loser attractor this month, Scorpios. You know, try and stay away from people who are not adding or who will not add any value to your life. So it's great that, you know, there's a great attraction that is there. There's a lot of chemistry that is there. But post it sort of where the love is concerned, you might want to save it for those who really value you and love you. And, so, you know, they will sort of sacrifice some bit of themselves as well, you know, for you. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Scorpio. I'll see you again next month. And thank you so much for watching.